Yes, good morning all the students.
Atali na?
Ha, yes sir. Good morning all the students. Welcome back to this very wonderful motivational session by CA Dhavre sir. Before proceeding forward, हमारे साथ आज सीए यशवंत कासार जी सर जुड़ गए हैं, हु इज रीजनल काउंसिल मेंबर एंड पास्ट ट्रेजरर ऑफ डब्ल्यूआरसी. एंड स्टूडेंट्स, आप लोग मेरे से बहुत बार पूछते हो कि हाउ यू कैन, आप इतना मोटिवेटेड कैसे रहते हो, इतना लीडरशिप कैसे करते हो. सो उसके पीछे जो एक रीजन है, तो दैट इज यशवंत कासार जी. बिकॉज ऑफ हिम आई हैव बीन ट्रेंड एंड जो सारे इवेंट्स ऑर्गेनाइज करता हूँ, दैट इज ऑल बिकॉज ऑफ दिस यशवंत सर. He is a very dynamic personality and unki wajah se I am here right now giving you the all the benefits of this online crash course. So without wasting much of the time, now I request CA Yashwant Kasar to give welcome address sir. Over to you Yashwant sir.
Thank you Rushikesh. Good morning all the students. It's indeed a very good opportunity for all of us to hear from CA SB Dhavre sir today in this inspirational series for CA students conducted by Satara branch along with other branches of WRC and ICI. This is a very good initiative, and motivation is something that every student is required in his life, and for CA student it is much needed. And if for such motivational session someone like Dhavre sir is there, I think it's a wonderful thing. To introduce about Dhavre sir, he needs no introduction among CA fraternity, but for those who are new, I will just briefly introduce CA SB Dhavre sir to all of you. CA SB Dhavre sir is a fellow member of ICI. He is a commerce graduate from the University of Pune in 1969. He has been awarded doctorate of philosophy, that is PhD, by Savitribai Phule University on the subject of standardization of accounting practices in agricultural sector in India. He is the former Central Council member of the ICI. He is the former chairman of Accounting Standard Board of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Then he is currently the chair of the Asia Oceanian Standard Setter Group. This Asia Oceanian Standard Setter Group is a group of 27 jurisdictions in Asia Oceanian region, and this group works towards the development of new accounting standard considering the situation in this Asia Oceanian region. So sir is the first Indian person to be the chair of this Asia Oceanian Standard Setter Group. He is the member of Accounting Standard Advisory Forum of International Accounting Standard Board of IFRS Foundation London for the term 2018-21. Then very important thing is sir is the inventor of the UDIN, that is Unique Document Identification Number, UDIN initiative. He is the inventor of that initiative. In his speech, he will tell us about what is that concept. Then sir has received Lifetime Achievement Award for his contribution to the field of Chartered Accountancy Education, Administration, Social Work, conferred by Maharashtra Cosmopolitan Education Society and Alana Institute of Management Sciences, Pune. A visionary and pioneer faculty in CA profession since more than four decades, he has taught more than 10,000 successful chartered accountants. He is the mentor and core faculty of the Dhavre's Professional Academy, Pune. Sir's journey in this CA profession is if we count from the articleship days, he has crossed more than 50 years journey in this CA profession. And in these 50 years, he has he was the practicing chartered accountant for 12 years. Then he worked in the industry for 12 years, and then academician, and now the leader of CA profession. So he has experience of all walks of the CA profession. Regarding his social contributions, He is the founder president of Gargundi Education Development Society in Ahmednagar district, a society which is helping hand for economically weak and talented students. So sir's introduction is very big, but this has given you a brief glimpse about his his profile. So we are really fortunate that we have sir with us to guide us, and he will guide us today on the subject of a path towards destiny, and definitely it will give us very useful insights to live our life, and for the students to very important inputs they need to follow as a CA student. So it's a wonderful opportunity, and without wasting much time, I think we are all very eager to hear sir. So I request Zahure sir to please begin with his presentation. Thank you. Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you, CA Yashwant Kasar, regional council member and the formal treasurer of the Western India Regional Council of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. Kind words of introduction. I am also thankful to Rishikesh Wangde, the dynamic chairman of the Satara branch of WIRC, for arranging this type of sessions for the benefit of the students. My dear and near student friends, welcome during the Corona lock period. It's the first day after 31st May, and I welcome you to the session of A Path Towards Destiny. First of all, I congratulate all of you for having joined the Chartered Accountancy course, because the future is very bright. But what is required? I must become a chartered accountant. And for that purpose, this particular session, motivation session, is to understand how I can be a successful chartered accountant, how I can be a successful professional. Somebody talked with me, sir, quote of the Bill Gates. What he said in one of the program, that I failed in some subjects in examination. And my friend passed all the subjects. He is engineer, and I am the owner of Microsoft. Now, Bill Gates is only one. I cannot have this type of motto. Because even though he failed, he has a motivation to be the entrepreneur, and he started the Microsoft and one of the most successful entrepreneur. Everybody is not Bill Gates, and therefore I have to find out my own path. How shall I walk on this difficult path? But it can be a simple for you after my entire motivated lecture. So please listen carefully, and at the end, we'll have question answer session 2. CA students normally say, never surrender. After May, there is November. If there is a will, there is a way. And after November, again there is May. My dear friend, in the opening remark, I can say the first attempt is the best attempt. At whatever the stage you are right now, either at the foundation level, or at intermediate level, or at a final level, this particular lecture or this particular deliberations is for all the students. What is required? Sincerity, commitment, dedication to self. And that is very important. Just to give little background, in 1969, long back when none of you were born, I completed my graduation and I started my chartered accountancy course. When I took advice of number of students who have joined the chartered accountancy course, they advised me that this course is not for you. You are from a rural area. You are from Marathi medium. And how can you pass the CA examination? But my dear friend, in my lifetime, I've never seen failure. But continuously, I have done my SWOT analysis. My strength, my weakness, my opportunities, my threats. And even at this age also, I continue to do so continuously in times to come. But for this purpose, you have to decide your own path. Everybody has a different strategy, and that strategy will depend upon your own SWOT analysis. I will talk with you. Exam tests your memory. Life tests your knowledge. And others will test your patience. My thinking all the time for the CA students is, I do not want to pass only the examination. I want to make my life. I want to change my life. And in order to change my life, I should be a knowledgeable person. I always say three things are essential. Number one is technical know-how. That is the knowledge base. Because I am appearing for a professional examination. Number two, practical do-how. I must do the sufficient practice of the concepts, whether it is theory or whether it is a practical subject. And third is very important, and today we are going to talk on that point, marketing know-how. I have to market myself. I have seen the students who have studied well, but they are not able to market themselves in the examination hall. And that is very important. Therefore, I said, examination tests your memory, life tests your knowledge, and others will test your patience. So what I require? I require memory, I require knowledge, and I require patience in order to reach my destiny. So we have to choose the different path. You are aware whether you should be in majority or whether you should be minority in order to pass CA examination. I have to be in minority. So I have to choose a different path. It is always said that successful person does the same thing, but he does differently. And that different approach, attitude, the way, the path, the road, I have to choose. When I was doing CA, one of our friend, he was sleeping during the daytime. And he was requesting us, no, today I will work tonight and it will be compensated. Same day night, he was sleeping again with a plea that, sir, I will get early morning, my friend, I will get early morning tomorrow and study. Early morning also, he was sleeping. And he said, no, this afternoon I will not sleep. But he was sleeping all the time. So what is your commitment? Then what is your dedication? So message is very simple. Sleep. Not sleep. Study while others are sleeping. Work when others are loafing. Prepare when others are playing. And dream while others are wishing. There is a difference between the wish and will. And therefore, I must have strong desire, strong willpower that I have to pass a CA examination. I have to be a professional. I have to change my life. I have to change the life of family members. I have to change my family. I have to change the people around me. And for this purpose, we have to go to the understand the path of the destiny. If you fail in an examination, it means you have not mastered the subject. And with diligent study, mastered the subject, and with diligent study and understanding, you will succeed. Failure is the first step towards success. It does happen sometimes. Nobody asks you a question after becoming a chartered accountant. How many attempts you have given for the CA examination? So you have to remember that success is not the key of happiness in life. Happiness is the key of success. Become a successful and be happy in life. If you love what you are doing, you will be successful. So first question I must ask to myself, do I like the chartered accountancy course? If the answer is yes, I have to fall in love with the chartered accountancy course. My dear friend, much good work is lost for the lack of little more. I'll explain. Much good work is lost for the lack of little more. Being a council member, former council member, number of times I analyzed the CA examination results, and I have found most of the students fail between 45% to 50%. Individual subjects they have passed, but in aggregate they are not able to make 50%. And between 45 to 50% is a major failure percentage. Why? And exactly what I said earlier, you have lost for the lack of little more. So when I prepare for 55%, I will get 50%. And for that purpose, my preparation should be full. And therefore, Swami Vivekananda said, don't stop until the goal is achieved. Stop not till the goal is achieved. Continue working hard. And therefore, I can say, don't stop when you are tired. Stop when you have done. That means when the work is complete, when you become a chartered accountant, you stop. Does not mean stop the education. Even as a chartered accountant, you have to be continue. You have to be a student throughout your life. So with this introductory remarks, I will take you through my presentation. And if anybody doesn't have a presentation, please contact Rishikesh Wangde, the chairman of the Tara branch of WRC, and get that presentation, because that will be very much useful to you. Next.
The links have been shared in this video itself for presentation. Students, the link for this presentation has been there in the description below this video. So you can download from there also.
Okay. How can I move, Rishikesh, next to the slides?
I will go. Yeah.
Okay. So please, according to me, you go ahead. No problem. One by one.
Yeah.
My dear friends, we are going to talk what in this session? I am going to share with you the key areas to review, you can say. So this is a professional examination. Don't forget. This is not normal university examination. Later on, I will give you differences also. I am stressing more today on SWOT analysis. Depending upon my strength, depending upon my weakness, depending upon the threats, I have to decide a strategy how I can be a successful examinee and reach the destiny. In order to do that, I will give you some of the key points, linkage points of the SWOT analysis. Then I have to understand and study the course contents, which you have, I hope you have already done. Very important is time management for studies. Time once gone, gone forever. And therefore, time is very precious. And I hope you are making a proper management of that time. Time is scarce, limited, and I have to pass the examination. So unless and until I plan, time management, not possible. Whatever the study you do has to be reviewed from time to time, because as a student, whatever you have studied, you have to store in your memory. Mere storage is not enough. You have to recall as and when required. And in the examination, you have to write down after recalling. Therefore, we will talk something about reviewing of the study, the help of the professional, and very important, communication. When I say the communication, now we are not going to talk about here the speaking skill in the examination. We are not talking about the reading skills, but yes, you have to have writing skills. And that writing skill also becomes very important along with your handwriting. We'll talk a little bit. I will also take you for planning for a week before the examination, checklist, entering the examination hall planning, and after examination, but before the result also, I am going to talk with you. Very important. After the examination, but before the result. Please understand. And that is very crucial according to me. Move further. You are appearing for a CA examination which is recognized in the world. Many Indian chartered accountants are well placed abroad. US, maybe Europe, maybe in Australia, maybe a number of Asian countries also, and naturally in India. You know the demand and supply. When supply is restricted and demand is more, there is a value. And just for information, though I have not shared in the PPT, that what is the statistic of a chartered accountant? In USA, per 10,000 population, there are 15 CPAs. In UK, the corresponding number is 18. Australia, 22. New Zealand, 42. I have taken the examples of developed countries. Look at India. You are aware the population of India, 130 crore. You are more than 130 crore. How many chartered accountants are there? There are around 350,000 chartered accountants are there. So 315,000 divided by 130 crore multiplied by 10,000. My dear friend, this number per 10,000 population, there are hardly 2.5 chartered accountants statistically. There is a demand. You can go to 15, you can go to 18, you can go to 22, you can go to 42. Corona, COVID-19 has destructed the entire world. M vitamin is very important. Every commercial organization, be a trader, be a manufacturer, be a service provider, he requires financial management. He has gone below the break-even point, below the cash break-even point. And for this purpose, who is going to help? And one of the key person is a chartered accountant. Because I say, chartered accountant is financial doctor. Chartered accountant is financial architect. Chartered accountant is financial engineer. Chartered accountant is financial lawyer. And very important, chartered accountant is business solution provider. M vitamin is very important. And therefore, this M vitamin means money management, which is scarce. And actually, this COVID-19 has taken back all the people. And in this scenario, chartered accountant has a lot of value, and we have to work during post-COVID-19. Let's see one by one of the key areas to be reviewed. The first one I talked about, that the CA examination is a professional examination. Please note that this is not ordinarily 10th examination or 12th examination or university examination where majority of the students pass. This is a professional examination. You may say, oh, sir, is it difficult? It is. But it is not impossible. And it is difficult, therefore there is value. Please note, if the examination would not have been difficult, who would have recognized a chartered accountant? This examination is conducted only by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India in India. The examination is at par or even above the standard with reference to international professional examination. And even the examination conducted by the AICPA of USA, American Institute of Certified Public Accountants. Therefore, passing this examination is considered as an attainment of highest order. You change your life. Once you become a chartered accountant, you have a lot of scope and prospects. But there are high standards in the examinations and even in the profession. And this is scrupulously maintained by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India. But at this point of time, can I say that the Institute never failed any student? Those who have passed with reference to the examination pattern and your answers, HIPAS, that is the reason why the examination percentage results sometimes change. But Institute never actually does that, maintain the result of 35%. Question doesn't arise. This assurance I can give you. Success in the examination depends upon the solidity of preparation and your sincerity. There is no option. And there is no easy way out to fulfill your dream and reach to the destiny. You have to work hard. Hard work is the key to success. I can give my own example. I was walking barefooted up to 10th standard, 14 kilometers a day, and that through Marathi medium. And even in college, actually during high school, I remember English was taught in Marathi. In college days also, most of the subjects were taught in Marathi only. Now in this case, I have decided my strategy. How can I pass the CA examination? And when I done my SWOT analysis at that time, I will tell you. So success needs no explanations and failure has none. Therefore, always keep in mind, if my mind can conceive, if my heart can believe, I can say, I know I can achieve. So you should have policy in your mind that my mind should conceive, I must believe, and I know I can achieve. That's why I say, do you like the core subject of accounting? Do you like financial management? Do you like cost management? Do you like chartered accountant C course? If you like it, do it and you can. The examination level of knowledge one must understand. Very few students are aware about this. And what is that? The expected level of examination is given by the institute that for foundation level, you require a fundamental knowledge, you require a basic knowledge. At intermediate level, you require reasonable working knowledge. Reasonable working knowledge. I hope you understand. Right? Income tax. Reasonably well, you should know. Because when you are studying the income tax, you should know reasonably well how to file an income tax return, how to compute the income. What do you mean by setup of losses? Again, under the same head, inter-head adjustments. Just for understanding. So reasonable working knowledge and at final level, advanced knowledge is required. That is, see, level of examination is different. And therefore, when I pass the foundation examination and I know I have to go to intermediate where the reasonable working knowledge is there, I have to change my strategy and I have to go into the more details. And at final level, advanced knowledge is required. And when I require the advanced knowledge, my dear friend, my study has to be in depth. So just to understand, let's move ahead and let's say, I hope you have the PPT with you so you can understand. University level examination and CA examination, what is the difference? And that is very important to understand, because in university, reasonable understanding is tested. But in CA examination, understanding of the subject is fully tested. There is a set pattern in university examination. But in CA examination, there is no set pattern. Examination is dynamic. It changes. So there is no question of set pattern. Though recently, some guidelines are given to you. As far as students are concerned, the examination, how the questions will be asked, etc. There is a reasonable presentation skill is required in university examination. But in CA examination, what I found in my student days, as well as a chartered accountant or an academician, the presentation of skills is required of high order as far as this examination is concerned. In university examination, practice makes students perfect. Take the examination paper of the last 5 examinations and you can pass the CA examination. But in case of the CA examination, I always believe you require strong fundamentals and basic understanding to make a perfect student, to reach the destiny. I just say that university examination, donkey work is more than enough. But in CA examination, monkey work also counts. In addition to donkey work, you have to do little more practice too, as far as practical subjects are concerned. In university examination, reasonable and functional knowledge is more than enough. But in CA examination, you must have technical and conceptual knowledge. I talked about the majority and minority. And very important, this is not an examination where you can work for the last 2 months and pass the examination. I have seen the merit ranker students also who work very hard throughout, not only in the last month. Therefore, in CA examination, continuous and planned studies make a student successful. So you have to plan. Time is crucial, and that we are going to talk also. Very important, you'll find in the next slide. There are 3 important aspects I must look into. When I have to achieve my target, when I have to achieve my dream, when I have to reach the destiny, what is important is accuracy, speed, and confidence. It is said that confidence is half success. And therefore, I should never lose confidence. But I don't get the confidence as it is unless and until I prepare fully for this examination. My confidence will not be generated. So once I have a confidence in myself, that means I am going in the right direction. Now, what is important is accuracy and speed in the examination. Now, when I have to be more accurate, my speed is reduced. And when I want more speed, it becomes inaccurate. Therefore, you have to balance the 2 wheels of accuracy and speed. And sometimes in the accuracy, students are not able to attempt more than 70-80 marks question paper. That is also dangerous. And the speed is also required because you have to be accurate as well as you have to maintain your speed. I always say that there are 3 essential qualities to become a chartered accountant. Number 1, watch time. And this is applicable to student also. Watch time. Time is very, very crucial. Time is money for us. maintain your speed and hit the target. So time management, maintaining the speed means even the steady coverage within the available time and hit the target, that is appear for the examination. Let's understand this SWOT analysis. You know this management jargon, that what is my strength, what is my weakness, what is my opportunity, and what is my threat. Let's analyze and then I will give my example also. What are the areas of strength? Strength for one can be a weakness for another. And when there is a weakness, my dear friend, that is a threat to many, those who have a weakness. That means I have combined together strength, weakness, and threat. Now you have to find out each aspect. You sit with meditation, analyze today itself, not tomorrow. Again, time is important. And let's see, one by one. First, I have started not technically, but I started with physical health. Health is wealth. And your health should be very good. You are a young persons, ladies and gentlemen. And your health should be absolutely well. But I find many students work up to 2 o'clock, get up at 10 o'clock, no exercise, no gym. Problem. You can't go against the nature. That's what we have seen in this corona time. Physical health is very, very important. And therefore, you have to maintain your health by doing the proper exercises morning. You can join my Facebook and you can see I've given the message recently. Sleep early, get up early, do exercise, do yoga, go to gym. Very important. I, at the age of 70, already walked 8 kilometers in the morning, for your information. So physically I am fit, absolutely no problem. So please ensure that physically you are well. Now we'll go to the technical aspects. Level of intelligence. I have seen during my professional life or as an academician, ordinary student has also passed CA examination. Intelligent student has passed. But please note, intelligent student have also failed CA in CA examination. But I must understand my level of intelligence, where I am, whether my intelligent quotient is low or medium or the high. This you can find out naturally from your past performance. That is not only, but you are aware whether I am less intelligent or I am more intelligent. Intelligence is required. Nowadays, what happened? Common sense is missing. I found many times in the classroom, see a final student, take a calculator, and he say 5 into 5 is equal to 20. What has happened? Sir, I have not made mistake. Calculator has made mistake. How can you say like this? You must have common sense. 5 into 5. How much it will be? I've just given simple example. Common sense. I should know the answer in general first. So please keep in mind my level of intelligence you analyze. My power of concentration. This is one of the biggest problem for the young generation. You can't sit at one place for more than a half an hour or 45 minutes or 1 hour. If you ask me to sit for 6 hours in concentrated and meditated position. So power of concentration, try to improve upon. There is no problem. If you are in a concentrated mood, please keep in mind whatever you study remains with you. And therefore, concentration power has to be increased. Whatever you read during concentration, you remember. When I was doing the study, I was finding that evening 5 to 7, my concentration is more. Early morning, my concentration is very good. But in the after the lunch, my concentration is not good. Then I was taking practical subjects. So please keep in mind, when your concentration level is high, difficult subjects you have to prepare when you are concentrated. Analytical mind. My mind must be analytical. I think this is very, very important. I consider. You know the situation. There is a question. There is a practical problem. After completing that problem, your mind should work that in case of the input changes from this to this, what is going to happen? A student, a father asked him a very simple question. The house was under refurbishment, maintenance, and the tiles were to be ordered. And then he asked a simple question. Father asked a simple question to a son who is doing the chartered accountancy course, how many tiles I shall order for the bathroom? My dear friend, now how we have to calculate, and for this purpose, he has not excluded windows, he has not excluded the door, he has not taken into consideration the number of the breakages, and he couldn't give the answer. Then what is this? Where is your mind is working? Chartered accountant is business solution provider. My mind should be analytical. I should ask the question to my mind. I should try to get the answers. If not, consult your friend, get the answers. Even at this age, I have a problem. And therefore, I consult the youngsters as far as computers are concerned, information technology is concerned. And Yashwant Kasari is one of the chartered accountant who guide me as far as information technology is concerned. So analytical mind, ambition, I should have ambition. I have to pass. I have to do. I must have optimism. I cannot go negatively. Life is beautiful. But for this purpose, you have to prepare. You have to get yourself motivated. And that too with dedication. Not only for today, that sir talked today about the motivation lecture. So I am motivated. Tomorrow morning, I will do the exercise. Day after tomorrow, you will forget. This is for times to come. Motivation and dedications. And very important, this is the examination of patience. Keep in mind, be patient. Slowly digest what you are learning. Now, we are talking about the strength as well as weakness. Please keep in mind all this. Language and communication is also important. No language. Many convent educated students have joined the CA course. But even today, there are many students from the rural areas, not only from Marathi medium, maybe Telugu medium, Hindi medium, Tamil medium, Kannada medium, they are also pursuing CA course. So the problem is, my English should be reasonably good. And this was my problem when I have done my CA. Let me complete this strength and then I'll talk about and what strategy I decided. See your level of competence and skills. Reading ability, very, very important. Why reading ability? I have to cover the entire books, material, input material given by the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, revisional test papers, theory modules, practice modules. And nowadays, my dear friend, I am always worried. Students are not referring to textbook. We were using the textbook when I was in CA. As far as costing part is concerned, I've used the book of W.W. Big, a foreign author. At least you use the textbook wherever you find a concept difficult, instead of reading the complete textbook. Because the material prepared by the Institute of Chartered Accountants in India is of the highest order, Board of Studies. And that is a gist from the textbooks. But wherever you are not able to understand clearly, where the concept is weak, you are not able to interpret in a proper way, please go to the textbook. And that is very important. Now, why I say reading ability? I found many students are not able to cover the reading itself before appearing the examination. That's what I'm going to talk about the planning also later. Your commitment level should be at the highest order, right? You must be courageous. I must have searching attitude for newer things. When I am studying a particular subject and go little after understanding the concept, go little after it and search for something. You know your academic track record. And then this last point is very, very important to me, and that is writing. My friend, my handwriting is not good, but my handwriting is legible. There are many students who are not, my one of the friend, chartered accountant, is not able to read what he has written. And then there is a real problem. Handwriting should be legibly good. What is the time available to an examiner to check your answer sheet? Limited time. And in that, he has to search what is this alphabet, what is this word, and what is this sentence, and what you are talking about. If you are not able to communicate, there is a problem. Handwriting should be reasonably good, legible. Legible. I am not saying it should be excellent, but it should be legible. One can read. So having understood the strength, weakness, and threats, strength for one, weakness for other, weakness is there, there is a threat. There is an opportunity. What is the opportunity? You have to become a professional. High remunerative prospects. Family background, entire changes, become a professional at an early age. At my time, we have done after graduation. You are doing after 12th. So you are becoming a professional at an early age. You deliver the professional services to the society. Gainful employment of knowledge in the field of accounts, finance, taxation, and whatnot. Because that's what I say. There are sea changes in the profession for the last many decades. And today the chartered accountant role is not of an accountant and auditor, but a change to a business solution provider. There is diversification from traditional educational courses, because here there is a articleship plus theoretical knowledge. This examination or degree is socially accepted, and you have an international employment opportunities on becoming a chartered accountant, and there are many MOUs also, MRAs also, of the Institute of Chartered Accountants with other counterparts. Now, let me tell you what was my problem. My problem was only one. I said, my strength, I am from village. I took as strength. I'm a son of a primary teacher. I said, I have to change my life. I am intelligent. I have commitment. I have the dedication to self. I will work hard. So number of strength I could find out. Then I said, what is weakness? Non-availability, money was not weakness. When I was doing CA, I have not taken dinner on Sundays. But that was not my weakness. My weakness was the way of communication. Having studied in Marathi medium, whether I will be able to write my answer sheet in correct English. And this was my weakness, I found out. Then how I removed it? I decided a strategy. And strategy was nothing but 60-40 formula. CA final students are aware about Pareto analysis, 80-20. I was not doing Pareto analysis at that time. But I have designed my own 60-40 formula. And you will be surprised, what is this 60-40 formula? Some of you can use it. And it was very simple. I found, after graduation, there was a direct entry for intermediate. So intermediate examination was for 600 marks at that time. And final examination was for 800 marks. Out of six subjects, three were practical, three were theoretical. Even in CA final, interestingly, I could find out of the eight subjects, four were practical, four were theoretical. Then I said, for practical subjects like accounts, financial management, costing, taxation, statistics, where do I require English? That much English is known to me. My English is weak, but not at a much lower level. I could understand, I could write reasonably. So, as far as practical subjects are concerned, there is no question of English, and therefore, in any circumstance, with my other strength factors, I must get minimum 60 in each practical paper. And as far as theoretical subjects are concerned, I have to get 40 in any case, then only I am going to pass the examination. And my dear friend, 60, 60, 60, 40, 40, 40, total is equal to 300 out of 600. The percentage marks are 50 and the result is pass. Same thing happened in CA final also. Now, this has helped me to be a successful examinee during that time. My marks are much, much better, not only 50%. But the strategy was important. And this strategy, many of you can follow, right? And please keep in mind, I have seen that those students who are from English medium, they have only passed, and other students have not passed, is not correct. Failure and the passing is not dependent on medium of instructions, but primarily it depends upon your solidarity of preparation for this examination. So I have given you some tips to remove the weakness or threat, that you have to develop your writing skills, and in real life, you have to develop your talking skills as well as listening skills. That is also very important, and that you have to develop right now also. Now, listen. People are not ready to listen. So for this purpose, communicate with friends in English. Read newspapers regularly. Problem for the students. I find three diseases for the students. What are the three diseases for the students? Number one, mobile. Excessive use of mobile. I am not saying don't use the mobile, but use the mobile only to the required extent, mobile or other gadgets. Number two, be aware about your friend circle. And number three, concentration. These are the three problem areas which I have to improve upon. How many students read the newspapers? How many students read the Economic Times and Financial Express? Please ask yourself. Refer English to English dictionary, not English to Hindi, English to Marathi. English to English, so you understand two words at a time. Add on the new words in your memory dictionary. Develop your communication skills directly in English. Thinking, don't do in local language, and then try to convert, but think directly in English, and that is possible, my friend. For this purpose, concentration, practice your meditation, because that is a power. Concentrated mind retain the studied matter and subjects effectively. Many times students say, sir, I remembered on that particular day, but in the examination, I am not able to recall, memory fail. That is the problem. For this purpose, concentration is must. Stress on understanding of the basics and the logic of the subject matter is very, very important. My dear friend, my past students, after the IFRS, they telephone me, sir, you taught me basic of accounting. Whether it is accounting standard or international financial reporting standard, doesn't make any difference. Logically, principally, fundamentally, I am absolutely clear about the subject matter. And if I are able to get that clarity on fundamentals, I think CA examination is not difficult. I already told you, I have not seen any failure in my life, and you will not also. But I therefore always say, first attempt is the best attempt. Mere quantitative inputs are not sufficient to clear the professional examination. Qualitative efforts are required. Many times students say, sir, I completed 2 rounds of studies. Quantitative rounds I don't want. 1 qualitative round is more than enough. Qualitative round means whatever I have studied, I'm able to store it, I'm able to recall it, I'm able to write down it. Conceptually clear, I'm able to understand, I have that confidence. So qualitative efforts are required. I already talked with you that study from the day one. Yesterday has gone forever, but you can catch today and the tomorrow. Very important. Sacrifice yourself. Please, you are not sacrificing for parents. You are sacrificing for yourself because you have to make your career. And devote sufficient time for planned and methodical studies. I am always of the opinion, continue sports and other activities of your interest about an hour. But keep in mind that CA course is core and it is a focused activity. Sometimes the student come to me, sir, I want to go to a drama. I want to play as artist. I want to be a sportsman. But I want to do CA course. I always say, when you have joined the Chartered Accountancy course, what is at your core and what is at peripheral? I want Chartered Accountancy course at the center and your other interest matters should be at peripheral. Otherwise, if you want to be a sportsman, put the sportsman at the center. Chartered Accountancy course cannot be at peripheral. Keep in mind. Therefore, CA course is core and a focused activity is there. In the next slide, I have just said, God gives every bird its food, but it does not throw into the nest. Bird has to take efforts to catch the food. The fool said, I have ruined my past and my present. You are wise. The wise said, but the future is still safe. So please catch on the future and make your career. That is very important. Sometime in the classroom, once I asked a question, and very, very simple question. A question is asked to a student by teacher, and immediately hands up of some of the students. And he has given some response, right or wrong, as the case may be. So I asked a question, why you responded immediately? You thought up, because I always want thinking and then acting. Don't act first and then think over. Now, this is very, very important. Thinking and acting. There are many who are not thinking, but they are acting. What happens, my friends? Inqualitative output comes out. Number two, some people think, but they don't act. What happened? There is no output, right? Because you are not expressing yourself. So what is required? Thinking and acting simultaneously. One by one, think, act on. It's very, very important. What do you get? Qualitative output. And that is what exactly required. After these three analysis, One student raised hand. Sir, you have forgotten one more. No thinking, no acting. No thinking, no acting, dormant output. Therefore, very important part, my friend, you have to think and you have to act. And for this purpose, you apply your studied subject matter with possible deviations and think of the revised output. So in the examination, you will be able to tell any type of question. Brave warrior Napoleon did not have no in his dictionary, and he always looked with optimism and positive attitude, and here nothing is impossible. Everything you can do it, and that's what is required. Past academic record is an outcome of efforts taken for the cause in the past. But you know, the level of examination and the marks for earlier examination and this examination differ, and therefore, keep in mind, this is a professional examination. Your success now will depend upon the future performance. Past is only a base. Therefore, I say, good seed sown always yields best plant and tasty fruits. Keep confidence in self. Healthy mind resides in healthy body. I started with that. Keep your health in upright position. Develop good habits of physical exercise, good habits of eating, and good habit of sleeping. Are you under the impression by working up to 2 a.m. you are working more? According to me, no. Because precious early morning time where you can concentrate more has gone. Sleep early, get up early. Decide. Distractions and temptations has to be avoided. This is a challenge to the boys. Whenever they come to cities, there are more distractions, and therefore temptations and distractions has to be avoided. You write your diary regularly. Now let's talk about little bit course and subject in a little bit hurriedly manner. The institute emphasizes testing comprehensively and concisely on the self-expression ability and application of the knowledge. Keeping this objective of high examination standards, let us find out a way out and decide upon the strategies. You are aware that ICAI has prescribed the subject and syllabus. Read the syllabus carefully and understand the topic. One student, 2 days before the examination, telephoned me recently and asked me a question. Sir, for income tax paper, which assessment year is applicable? My dear friends, so what has happened? He has not prepared earlier, and therefore there is a problem. So please keep in mind, you must understand the entire syllabus and you have to cover it fully. Don't leave any topic uncovered. And this is my appeal to you. I must appear for 100 mark paper, not 70, not 80. You are increasing the risk. One simple strategy of success is minimum risk, maximum reward. So for this purpose, what is required? I must attempt 100. Maybe your 20 mark difficult question is wrong. I can tell you of November 1970 examination of CA intermediate. In this paper of accounts, there was a question on costing break-even point. Simple question was there, but we have not studied. At that time, marginal costing was in CA final examination. On reading the question paper, I found this. I don't know the answer, how to calculate it. So I kept at the last. And surprisingly, my friend, after completing all the remaining questions, when I read that, I applied my common sense, I applied my knowledge of economics, that what is break-even point? No profit, no loss point. Or sales minus variable cost, that is contribution, is just equal to fixed cost. Or the sales are equal to total cost. This was only a common sense I applied. And I completed that difficult question for me within 7 minutes. When the time available was 15 minutes for that particular question. So you can never bow down try to understand, interpret, cover more. So don't leave any topic uncovered. Check up the institute's prospects also. Syllabus you must understand completely. Very, very important. Go to the study material. Institute has prepared the best study material. Go through the conceptual, that is theory, practice module, suggested answers, revisional test paper, the accounting standard, auditing standard, guidance note of the institute, wherever required. You can use allied material also if the time availability is there. Like institute's chartered student journal, how many students read? I don't know. Chartered accountant journal, how many students read? You must attend the topic of your interest. You should spare some time for that. And then I said, how I study the practical subjects? I already told you that practical subjects give the surplus. That was my strategy. Because many students fail because they are, and in accounts paper, if my marks are 43 and 44, believe me, how can I pass CA examination? If a costing paper, my marks are 43, I require support to costing paper. Who will give the support? Corporate laws can't give the support. May not. Cannot is not right. May not. That's why depend upon practical subject that I have to generate surplus in order to aggregate 50% mark. In practical subject, try to understand the concept first. Understand the fundamental. Understand the accounting entries. Understand the logic of break-even. What is the difference between the break-even and cash break-even? How do I calculate the sale when there's a profit? Once you understand the conceptual part, I think no problem. To begin with, solve the simple problems. But when I have seen some student read the answers of account paper, there is a question on consignment, there is an answer, and you tick mark one by one. Is it a way of practical subject preparation? I have to solve it by my own hand. Otherwise, in the examination, your hands will tremble down. So please keep in mind, solve the problems. Don't mug up. Don't read. I never remember having mugged up any accounting entry nor advice to any student to mug up the accounting entry. I must understand from the heart. I must prepare in such a way they understand the subject. Then there is no problem. Right? Investment account topic, for example. How do I value the investments? Then you must understand the cost formula, first in, first out. Average cost, periodical average, weighted average, how do I calculate it, right? And so on. So once it is, there is clarity on different methods, absolutely there is no problem. In case of a joint venture, student faces a problem when accounting entries to be written in one book, only my own transactions are to be recorded or all transactions are to be recorded, then joint bank account, I must have clarity for this. What is the difference between the joint venture and consignment account? I must have clarity. I must have the clarity. What is title in the property? I must have clarity. What is sale of goods means? So basic fundamentals are important. Then you have to understand the advanced concepts also, because when you come to the CA final, there are standards and there are many changes, and now IFRS is also there. Practice advanced problems. Solve the past examination problems. Many students are afraid to give the test, and that is one of the problems. You have to create a confidence, then you have to check up. I always say, make mistakes, no problem, but don't repeat the same mistake again. So what shall I do next time? Make another mistake, but don't repeat that mistake again, right? Elimination of mistakes is path of perfection, and that is what exactly required. After solving the problem, think of possible change in input data. That in case if this input data is changed, what happened? Process one and process two, process costing. There is a difference. Because first raw material is input and second process is output of the first process is input. Further material is added later on. So please keep in mind, make the possible changes and try to understand. read the question carefully, try to understand, avoid silly mathematical errors. Many times in a hurry, accuracy and speed I talked about, the student make silly mistakes. Theoretical subject is a descriptive subject. Lot of time is required for theoretical subject preparation. Theoretical paper subject may not give surplus, may not plan like that. On the contrary, surplus marks are required for theoretical paper, so you have to generate from practical subjects. Again, here also try to understand the basics. But what I feel, you should have your own notes. You should have own highlighting. You should have your book of highlights, so that in the last week, 1 week before the examination, you will be able to read your notes and always do one thing. Whenever you have made a mistake, make one small booklet and write down what are the mistakes you made. Because those mistakes are not to be repeated again. And just a few days before the examination, go through. Because how you overcome that mistake, how you understood, that is important. Because these book of highlight or mistake book will give you the guide for preparation in few weeks before the examination. Always keep in mind, for theoretical subject, lot of time is required and you have to plan accordingly. One thing at this moment I will talk about, and that is, how many subjects I prepare at a time? One, more than one. Prepare two, three at a time. Morning one, afternoon one, evening one, no problem. But keep in mind, there are two type of subjects are there. The subject where you are good and the subject where you are weak. What is the normal tendency of a student? Normal tendency of a student is, wherever I am good, I prepare for that subject only. And I don't prepare for the subject which is very difficult. One of my students, in CA final examination, she secured 99 marks in advanced accounts in CA final. And she telephoned me after the result. Sir, I got 99 marks in advanced accounts. She started crying. I thought it's a joyous cry. She continued crying. After 5 minutes, she said, sir, I failed in CA final examination. Okay, she couldn't talk at that time. I telephoned afterwards. I asked a question. When you got 99 marks in accounts, why you only 38 marks in corporate laws? Sir, I don't like that subject. I know prepared well. I never liked that subject. My dear friend, don't do that. The you like and your disliking and liking is not your choice. Your choice is whether you want to become a chartered accountant or not. That's your choice. Therefore, always have more time on that subject where you are weak, not on a subject where you are comfortable. Right? Plan to write all the theory questions in the examination. Most of the students write a paper only of 80 marks. That is not enough. Write something more. Whatever you can. Maybe right or wrong, but with your common sense, with your study, whatever you are able to answer for a difficult question, do it. Answer all questions in good manner, because and better handwriting in best possible manner. Always look at the focus of the question, because you should do the answer to that question asked for. In an intermediate examination, if there is a question of what is HUF, if a student writes, sir, HUF is Hindu undivided family. Finish. Question maybe for 2 marks. Is it enough? Is it required in the CA examination that Hindu undivided family HUF full form out to you? Why Hindu undivided family taxation is important? And what is exactly the Hindu undivided family consist of? You are not given a technical answer. Marks will be zero. Right? So very important. Now, Writing practice is a must to get the confidence and speed. Your problem, the problem of your generation is you can't write. Problem of my generation, we are writing, writing, writing. We are writing the letters also to a father, letters to the parents, letter to friends. Writing practice required. Solve the past examination papers. Your length of the answer should depend upon the how many marks question is asked. If a question is asked for 4 marks, write 5 lines, but that should be summary, gist. But if the question is asked for 10 marks, go with illustrations, go with examples, go with clarity of the question. Present answer point-wise wherever possible. Come to arrive at logical conclusion. Give the facts of the case, suitable examples, related data in a brief manner, but that will depend upon how many marks the question is asked. Language carries a greater weight for higher marks. Sometimes students ask me, intermediate and final, sir, is it compulsory to give the case law? Case law has a weightage. In order to pass, I will not say it is required. But still, you should know the landmark judgments. And therefore, you have to have one small booklet, landmark judgments, for each topic of taxation. So putting a section and getting the case law for the law subjects has value-added effect. But one thing is very important. This is professional examination. Don't bluff. If you start bluffing, the confidence in that student is lost, and there will be further repercussions. If you are not able to answer, but don't bluff, don't give the wrong answer. Because this study sometimes works in university examination, not in the CA examination. Book of highlight is nothing but your own notes, clippings, important findings in a separate notebook, which is of immense use for preparation at 11th hour. Highlight important points in the book itself. List down the difficult topics. Write down your mistakes. Right? And that's very important. Now in CA final, you have to choose optional subject also. Choose of your own interest where you have to devote a lot of time. My point is once very simple. Cover the entire syllabus. When I was appearing for CA final examination and standard costing, and especially fixed overhead variance analysis, I couldn't understand. So I have to go on to a senior student. He said, keep it option. I've gone to a chartered accountant. He said, I had also kept an option. I've gone to cost accountant. He confused me. I was keen to cover that topic also, but I could not. And when I became a teacher, at that time I understood what is variance analysis. Time management of studies, time is very important. I think I should spend little time on this. Based on your SWOT analysis, you have to plan. Time is crucial. Time wasted is forever. Plan the studies from the beginning of the coursework. Prepare weekly timetable. I've given some suggestions here, right? That timetable simple, take more than 2-3 subjects and try to cover it. Whatever the backlog, Sunday is not holiday. Is the Sunday holiday for lunch and dinner? No. As a student, you don't have a holiday. Even as a working people, Sunday is not holiday for us. We do homework. Homework means housework. We help our the spouse for the purpose of helping her. So please note that Sunday is not a holiday. You have to work on Sunday. Try to cover your backlog. See this timetable. All the I've given you number of things how to plan the timetable. Help of coaching, you can go through. According to me, review of studies is very important. Success in professional examination lies in recalling and presenting the technical information in a marketable manner. I talked about marketing know-how, and therefore reviewing of your studies is important. Sometimes as a teacher, I have given a technique. Try to understand the technique if you can. I have studied a particular subject today. In the evening, when you go to bed and the light is off, try to understand, put on a screen, what I call as artificial screen. And on that artificial screen, whatever you have studied during the day, try to bring it. More darkness, more bright artificial screen. And try to recall what you have studied and what is that concept. And if you are able to recall, no problem. Sleep well. If you are not able to understand, oh, forgotten. Not able to recall, memory, lost. Get up from the bed. Sit on the table. Take out that concept. Read, understand, recall. See, whatever you have studied, you have to review it. Once you review it, once you ask the questions to yourself, you remember forever. And that's important. Right? So reviewing of studies is very important. Keep in mind that a winner does the same thing, but he does the same thing differently. Hence, plan for the winning strategy. Plan for success. Don't plan for failure. Attempt test series of the institute or otherwise everywhere. Communication, I talked a lot. No problem. So go through that. Communication is very important, but communication is only a vehicle. Wherein, whatever you have prepared last 10 months, 1 year, 2 year, in CA final, 2 years, you have to write down within 3 hours. And writing within 3 hours, my dear friends, you have to completely give the gist, right? How the politician, he talks within a couple of minutes what is done. So that skill you have to develop, and this is possible only through writing skill. So present yourself in a proper manner. That is the success of communication. Articleship exposure is have lot of importance as far as CA examination is concerned. I want to highlight two practical examples I want to give you. In CA final examination, in auditing paper, I had a compulsory question number one about foreign collaboration and verification of royalty payment. Now, foreign collaboration in the book or a material is very less. But during my articleship with, at that time, Bajaj Tempo Limited, now Force Motors Limited, there was a German collaboration. Complete file I had handled. That what is foreign collaboration, what type of agreement, how to calculate the royalty, what is minimum rent clause, and so on. My dear friend, I could answer that question confidently only on the basis of articleship exposure. So what you study where, or what you do in articleship, your exposure may be useful in the examination too. Similarly, I had a friend's collaboration suggestion somewhere in the slide that might have gone, that we were five friends together and we were always talking about whenever there is a time, we are sharing. One of our friends was doing LLB and Doctrine of Indoor Management in Corporate Law. We are using the Esham Shah's book. It had only 5 lines. And in my intermediate examination, compulsory question for 20 mark on Doctrine of Indoor Management, give suitable illustrations. First, there was a problem. Oh, 5 lines in the book. But one day, our friend who was doing LLB has given a lot of examples of Doctrine of Indoor Management. And only based on that discussions and deliberations, you remember, you recall, and you could write. So this articleship exposure is very important for accounting, for auditing, for taxation. And therefore, please do articleship meticulously. It's a lifeline. And that is the beauty of the course. And that is very important. Please keep in mind. So articleship exposure, keep your eyes, ears, and mouth open. Talk with the people. Learn new and newer things. It is not a burden for you. It is your lifeline. Result criteria, you are aware. Therefore, I will not talk about intermediate, final, additional time available, right? You have a number of advantages. Only I have given passing percentage 30, 25, 15. In general, I have given. But this examination is not difficult. No problem. Go ahead. And now, according to me, planning of a week before the examination is important. Examination is 1 week ahead, right? By the time you are fully prepared, that's what my presumption is. Hence, keep your confidence at the highest level. I told you, confidence does not come like that. I cannot bring confidence. I can't buy it. I have to build it. And that is building by way of your solid preparation, proper understanding. But one disease is there 1 week before the examination, and there is called examination fever. Now, this fever, neither the parents can cure, nor a doctor can cure. Keep in mind, very, very important. I will give one example. One of my student, earlier night examination tomorrow, he came to my house, knowing well, I sleep at 10 o'clock. He came at 10:30, put a bell. I saw from the gallery. As soon as he entered my house, I have given one slap. Best of luck. That's all. I understood he has examination fever. He was 50th merit ranker. He was to skip the examination. Because, sir, I am not feeling well. There is a temperature in the body. I am shivering. I am not able to recall. Don't lose your confidence at 11th hour. You only have a control on yourself. You are a creator of your life. Nobody else, neither the teacher nor a parent, is a creator. You are a creator of your life, and therefore, please keep in mind, keep your confidence or solidarity of preparation at highest level in 1 week. Therefore, what I suggest, 1 week before the examination, don't discuss with friends any topic except specific difficulty. Don't discuss any general. I remember when I was in CA final, and there was a gift tax was there, and one day before, one of my friends started talking with me, giving section-wise information of the gift tax. I was not able to recall. I said, please stop it. No problem. My friend, he failed in the examination. I got good marks in taxation paper. So please keep in mind, don't discuss with friends. Take the help of a professional who is your friend and guide for any difficulties. Now, very important, your notes, clippings, highlighting in a brief manner, mistakes. Go through that. Difficult topic, difficult question, tackle. So your notebook or book of highlights is very important here. Prepare for more than one subject, 2-3 subjects at a time. Revise your clipping. Revise your difficult topics. Check up the landmark cases. Go through the revisional test paper. Recall the formats of like banking company, insurance company, electricity company. Right? These formats, you go through it. What is important is last week is physical health is most important because mental health required. Can you imagine? One student slept during examination paper timing. He has forgotten. Because he's sleeping in the afternoon. He was working whole night. And during the day, he was sleeping. He has forgotten that there is a tomorrow examination is there and he was sleeping. There was no alarm. What is this carelessness? You are appearing for a professional examination. There are many silly examples are like this. I have given a pen and a ruler to a student in the examination hall. Calculator I purchased 3 times and given to student. What is this carelessness? You must be fully prepared. Therefore, please keep in mind what is the examination timing accordingly 2 months before. Don't sleep during that time. Right? Minimum sleep of 6 hours required. I am recommending 7 hours. But examination time, all right, 6 hours. Relax even 1 week before also. Avoid taking medicines except those are essential. Take doctor's advice. Avoid eating in restaurants and unknown joints. Checklist to proceed examination hall according to me is very important. It says what sir has given this. Today is talking motivation lecture and he's giving whether admit card is there, whether ruler is there, pencil is there, 0.5 pencil is there. Please go through these instructions carefully because these are the rare examples where as a parent, whether as a teacher, we have helped the student. But they are carelessness and that is to be avoided. So see the checklist, no problem. Now my last part is, okay, not last, one last. At the examination hall, don't become panicky. don't get excited, give your best. And one strategy, my first paper is very difficult. I don't want to appear for the second one. Never do it. What has happened in the first paper happened. Don't discuss with anybody. Go to the second paper. Appear fully. There are many cases. The paper was difficult, but he has passed. Okay, less marks. Doesn't make a difference. You have the remaining papers in your hand. Answer it well. So don't be panicky. Don't get excited. Give your best till the last minute. Go on, continue your writing until the supervisor wants to take the paper. Use the time. You have paid for it. Do it. I always give the example. I don't have time to go to cinema theater, but I go there unless and until up to the end, I sit in the chair. Why? I paid for it. Similarly, examination, you have paid for it, do it. Enter the examination hall, instructions are also given. That is important. Do and don'ts in the examination hall are also given. You go through it, no problem. Margin of a paper essay are given. Yes, important. Examination hall planning given. Go through it completely. I want to tackle the last is very important after the examination and before the result. Most of the students, majority of the students, why majority? 80-90% of the students don't prepare further. They are waiting for the result. Don't do it. As soon as the exam is over, please analyze yourself. What is the percentage marks you are expected? You know it well. Correct? You analyze, sit calm and quietly. And unless you are expecting 55-60% marks with minimum 40 marks in each subject, start preparation from the next day. That's why this examination of patience. Because what happens after the result? Again, 1 week, sorrow week. Then you start preparation. So I don't have any mood to prepare, but do the studies further. Because that is second attempt, third attempt. And then the time is less. And again, inadequate time. Therefore, after the exam and before the result, I think this time is crucial. Analyze yourself. And based on analysis, start preparation for the examination again. Having read the subject again, there is no loss. Or at least the common subject like taxation, common subject like GST, common subject like auditing, common subject like accounting standards, auditing standards, you can prepare because that is the time available for you. So after the examination and before the result, you can prepare it. That's very important. Go through it. So my dear friends, this is what actually various tips I've given to you to be a successful examination. And at the end, I say, Haar nahi hoti. Laharon se dar kar, nauka paar nahi hoti. Koshish karne wale ki, haar nahi hoti. Nanni chiti, jab dana lekar chalti hai, chadti diwari par 100 baar fisalti hai, man ka vishwas, ragon mein saahas bharta hai. Chadkar girna, girkar chadna, na akharta hai. Aakhir uski mehnat bekar nahi hoti. कोशिश करने वाले की हार नहीं होती. Entire poem is also in the PPT as a last slide. Thank you for your patient hearing and I hope get motivated and work for yourself. Time is crucial. Do it. I wish you all the best. I pray Almighty to add to your prosperity, subtract your worries, multiply your happiness, divide your problems with equal number of solutions. Thank you. All the best. Questions and answers. Rishikesh.
Thank you, sir. Rishikesh is having some technical difficulties, so I am standing in for him.
He is from Goa branch?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Have you heard me?
Yes, sir, absolutely. I have heard you. I'll just add Yashwan, sir, also to the broadcast. We have got Yashwan Kassar, sir. So I think Kassar, sir, will have questions for Rauri, sir, now.
Hello, Gaurav.
Yes, sir. Hello, how are you?
Yes, sir. Dear friends, Zahure sir has given us very, really very useful insights for a CA student, how to prepare for studies and for the exams. And these are practical insights, practical inputs. And I'm sure that this will definitely help for each and every participant here. Friends, I have few questions for Zhavre sir on behalf of all of us. Sir,
questions of the students are there, Ishwan? Any they have put in the chat box? Any questions?
I will just highlight them, sir.
That will cover and then you can talk about. No, let us cover students' questions first, and then we'll talk.
Yes,
about. Even though it is delayed by 10-15 minutes, doesn't make a difference for the students.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes, so one question is that they are discouraged to take more than one author or ICI books don't cover all concepts. So please guide us also or help on referring which books they should refer. I think this is a very specific question on the current thing. But sir, any guidance on this can you give?
Actually, what will you do? See, Institute's material is the best material prepared by the Board of Studies of ICAI. Still, I said, as far as conceptual part is concerned or basic fundamentals are concerned, you may have a difficulty or you have to have more case studies, more practical things for which I advise you to refer the textbook. There are many textbooks are available. Now, giving the name of particular textbook, there will be a problem right now. Because if I give am I favored with that author? The answer is no. Send me email. I have given email. I will definitely answer your question privately.
Okay. So the next question is how to prepare for taxation subjects. So I think this is a very relevant question. Even I have faced this issue. So sir, please guide us on this.
Okay. I do not want as a student for you to study section by section. I want first you have a general understanding in an intermediate examination. How do you have a general understanding? By topic, starting with introduction, starting with the definition, starting with income from salaries, income from house property, topic by topic, understand, and naturally sections are also covered. However, if you have a difficulty in particular topic or particular matter, go back to the Income Tax Act, go to the Income Tax Rules and try to understand it. I said very specifically, intermediate examination, you should have reasonable working knowledge, and final examination, you must have advanced knowledge. So at final level, your preparation must be in more depth as compared to the intermediate examination. And income tax is such a subject that whatever you have covered in intermediate is totally repeated as far as final is concerned. Because there may be some question from the topics of intermediate examination also. So what you should do, you should prepare from a good textbooks, right? Institute's material is also good. Please keep in mind, a lot of things we have, I myself has given number of suggestions to the Board of Studies and they have changed accordingly. So please prepare it, and wherever there is a clarity problem is there, refer a textbook. That means the income tax paper is to be prepared just like any other law paper.
Okay, so next question is very interesting. What are the new areas of opportunities for CAs as per you? I think there are new opportunities coming up due to the adversity of COVID. So
yes. My first sincere advice to him is become a chartered accountant. N number of opportunities are available to a chartered accountant. When I say that, chartered accountant is a financial doctor, and I have gone up to chartered accountant business solution provider. Becoming a chartered accountant gives you the minimum professional qualification. What I have to do further depends upon your inputs and your solidarity. I can only say, as a professional, once you become a chartered accountant, you have ample scope available as a professional is concerned.
Very true, sir. One more very relevant question. How do you keep away from addictions and distractions? I think they are increasing day by day. We have got WhatsApp, Twitter, Facebook, TikTok, and n number of distractions. So how can the students keep away from this, sir?
For this purpose, I said there are three diseases are there, commonly found diseases, and there is more to boys, girls also. Not that girls are not there. One is I talked about mobile. Number two, I talked about friend circle. And third, I talked about concentration. A medical doctor will not be able to give any advice on this, even though these are the diseases. How do you cure it? First, you must have self-confidence. I will do this and I will not do this. My do's and don'ts, I have to predefine. And I have to keep utmost confidence in me and leave that friend circle who add on to addictions and distractions. Because when you discuss the Twitter with your friend, you also go on Twitter. When your friend circle, friend talks about a particular movie, you find out a time and see the movie and so on. Therefore, according to me, friend circle is very, very important. Who should be your friends? I always talk, even in professional circle. To become my friend, somebody has to spend with me not less than 1 year. But here, in young generation, they become a friend within a couple of hours. So take precautions. Prevention is better than cure. When you are addicted, very difficult to get de-addicted.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. I think now we can take over. Kasar sir can ask a few questions from his side. We have handled quite a few CA students' questions. So, Kasar sir, please.
Yes, Gaurav. Sir, one question to you is, at this age of 70, you have completed your doctorate. So, the question in our mind is, what makes you keep going at this age? With the same enthusiasm, with the same energy level, what you do to maintain that enthusiasm and energy level? What you guide students regarding this?
Yashwant, you asked very good question to me. And the answer what you will get is maybe completely different than imagined by the student. Doing the PhD at the age of 69, that I have done in March 2019, why I have done the PhD? Is it for monetary gain? The answer is no. Is it for fame? The answer is no. Is it for getting additional knowledge? Answer can be partly yes. But more important than this, the background is totally different. Being a friend, philosopher and guide to many chartered accountants, and when I was in public life since 2009, I meet at the branches at number of seminars, conferences, nationally, internationally, number of students. They ask, many members ask me one question. And that question is, sir, like you, I have to become a teacher. I have to join some college. I have to join institution. So I said, do it. He said, no, sir, they are asking that you are only become CA. They are not recognizing my CA degree. They want MCOM. Later on, they want MPhil. Later on, they want doctorate. Then only it is possible to take in the colleges and institutions. I said, then do it. Sir, now MCOM, 2 years, I have to spend time. How can I do it? PhD, 4 years, how can I do it? And everybody said that they have a wish, but they don't have strong willpower. Then one day came to me, sometime being just analysis in mind, I said, why not to do it? I should do it and demonstrate. Age is not a bar for education. And I have done on my own that my difficulty was to find out a guide and a tutor for me, especially for the PhD. That was a difficult task. And next 3 years, I worked on Saturdays, Sundays, 4 weeks to Delhi and coming Saturday, whole night workout, your presentation, your thinking, because my guide said, this is totally new subject for me. So primarily, this PhD has been pursued to show age is not a bar. If you have strong willpower to become a teacher, you have to join institution, you have to follow UGC rules, and you have to do PhD. When my viva was there in the university, at that time, many those wishful chartered accountants joined my viva. And after the end, I also talked a little bit and I said, who want to do PhD? The four hands were up. And they said, we want to do PhD. But unfortunately, Yashwant, I have not, don't remember their names and not write down. But after that, since March 2019, till date, nobody has approached me. Really, I want to do it. Busy man only can find out a time is the second message. I didn't have a time, still I can do it. And time management is possible.
Thank you, sir. So another question is, as I observe you since last many years, you follow your routine. Early morning, you go for walk. Wherever you are, whether you are in Pune, whether you are at Delhi or any place, you do not miss, you always follow your routine, whatever may be the day. And you are always disciplined.
There was not the exception.
Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah. So, sir, this discipline you follow, and you have also talked about the physical fitness at the exam time. But throughout the life, you are nurturing the physical fitness in your life. So what you suggest or say to the CS students about the physical fitness, the importance of physical fitness, and how to maintain the discipline in daily routine? Because many of us, we struggle to maintain the daily the discipline in the routine.
I therefore, in the beginning itself said, mental health lives in physical health. Physical health is very important because I require energy. I require positive attitude. And for that purpose, for a student also, this is very, very important. And for that purpose, we have to follow natural life. Recently on my Facebook, I have put life lessons. 13 lessons I have given on my Facebook. Anybody can see also, no problem. And in that, I have given about the exercise. I have given about the gym. I have then given about the yoga. Because you have to do it. There is no alternative. This is the rule of nature. Right now, actually, I am in a little bit away from a city. And I find early morning at 5:30, birds are there. Right? So I also get to wake up at the same point of time. And birds are so disciplined. It's after 7 p.m., I can't find a single bird anywhere. That means they have a disciplined life. Why not an individual can also have a disciplined life so that you can achieve the purpose of your life? So in order to achieve the purpose of your life must be disciplined. You have to decide the do's and don'ts. And once that demarcation is clear, and once one is committed and dedicated to self, you can improve upon. But physical health is integral part of your success in your life. That's what I can talk about.
Thank you, sir. Sir, another question is, your life journey is very, is such that you started from a son of a primary teacher from a small village, learned in Marathi medium, then you became CA, then throughout the, you have achieved many professional successes. Then you have became, now became the chair of the AOSSG, that is comprised of 27 jurisdictions in Asia, Oceanian region. And you have seen such a transition of CA profession, how it was 40 years back, 50 years back, and how it is now. And you are also working at international level, and you are also witnessing how the CA profession professionals are doing all over the world. So how you see to this transition, and what you tell the students about the new professional opportunities that they have internationally also at this juncture?
Okay.
As an Indian chartered accountant.
During my talk also, I said there are sea changes in the profession. Starting from the manual accounting to computerized accounting, accounting standards, auditing standards, ethical standards, changing companies act, and information technology today. Many of my counterparts, they have not gone out with the information technology and they are outdated chartered accountant long back. Similar thing would have been with me also, in case if I would not have adhere to the technology. I'm not claiming at all that I know, I might be knowing that 5% technology only, not 95% unknown. Still, I'm learning, and youngsters are my teachers for that purpose. But during these changes, two things are important. Information technology, as a for chartered accountant is concerned, is a tool. Unless and until you want to decide the line of information technology, I want to work only with the team of information technology as a key person. That is something different. Because for the purpose of making the software also, the technical people are not able to understand the accounts and finance, for which a lot of inputs is required for preparation of software packages. Then you can do it. But in order to carry on a profession, or in order to carry on employment successfully, you must adopt the new technology. You have to adopt artificial intelligence, ABCD, what they talk about, the blockchain technology or cyber security and so on. So what is opportunities are many. Our basic opportunity will remain as it is, and that is accounting, auditing, and taxation. And in this taxation, GST is a new opportunity, has already come. Government want GST reconciliations completely good as far as India is concerned, but there has become complicated task, and especially in COVID-19 further aggravated. But primarily, the chartered accountant has today an opportunity of a financial doctor. MSMEs, as well as large industries, are facing the problem of financial discipline. And for that purpose, even vitamin is very important. Management of money, financial planning. So the chartered accountant can actually give sincere advice of the financial planning and financial accounting. I'm not talking really accounting, because accounting is nowadays done by computer, but financial planning is done by individuals. So the chartered accountant has to think ways and means how there can be value addition to the business. To give a simple example, I worked in one organization. Again, at that time, computer technology was limited. Limited means really not available, 1978 to 1985. I was working with one NGO. An NGO started manufacturing vaccine for foot and mouth disease vaccine for cattle, right? Crossbred cattle. And actually, the day Prime Minister of the country at that time, Morarji Bhai Desai, was to inaugurate a plant, and the price per 100 ml vial was 16 rupees, 1-6. The day when inaugurated, one of the multinational private company, Hest, they have reduced the price from 16 to 12 rupees. Later on, 12 to 9 and 9 to 8. And at this point of time, entire our financial planning was based on 16 rupees, 15 rupees, not 16, 15 rupees. And this was NGO, so funds were limited availability. At this time, the task was given to me, what are the way out for financial stability? And for this purpose was costing. Either you increase the volume, increasing the volume, selling price was reduced substantially, decrease the cost was only the solution. And I have taken a lot of interest. And by doing the costing, the cost of manufacturing the vaccine reduced substantially for 3.2 million doses at that time. Later on, it will become 50 million doses. So you can value addition.
Thank you, sir. Sir, one more thing. Throughout your life, you are following the perfect mantra, which is devised by you always in your speeches. You tell about that. And if you can tell us some background about the invention, how you have devised that mantra, and what the importance of that mantra in CA students' life. And another thing is, if you can elaborate something about Udin for the knowledge of the CA students over here.
First, I will answer the question of mantra of success, that is perfect. This is a story of 1978. Then I was working with one large NGO, and my mentor,
Dr. Manibhai Desai, a true disciple of Mahatma Gandhi, who fought for Britishers, but finally came to Ahimsa and joined the Mahatma Gandhi movement and worked with NGO, formed the NGO. And actually, in that, I found him a person who is a backbone for millions of the rural people who developed the technology of prosperity, wild evolution, agroforestry, water management, and number of other things. Now, at that time, I was thinking about that what is the do and don'ts. And for the purpose of success, at that time, in my account department, 40 people were working. So, on a foundation day, I put my mantra success before the feet of Dr. Manibhai Ji. And that perfect mantra is, my friend, to be followed by not only by professionals, everybody, but primarily we have prepared for chartered accountants and professionals. The first C stands for professionalism. That is, you have to be a professional. You have to follow professional ethics, you have to follow professionalism, you have to update yourself, knowledge, etc. Number of things are involved in that. E is effectiveness. I have to be effective in my life. R, very important, I talk today with you, regularity. One day is not enough. 1 week is not enough. 1 month is not enough. 10 years are not enough. For times to come. That regularity is required. It is firmness. Whatever I talk about, I should talk firmly, that with confidence. And when it is possible, only when I do full home exercise, I understand the subject, I understand the basics, what I have to talk tomorrow, so that firmness is required. Next key, I insisted today, that is SWOT analysis of the self. I should do my SWOT analysis in times to come, almost daily, almost periodically. SWOT analysis. Who says I am perfect today? The answer is no. I pray Almighty to become perfect until the end of my life. So that self-evaluation, SWOT analysis. My strength, my weakness, my opportunity, my choice. Today's weakness is tomorrow's my strength. Weakness becomes an opportunity for me. And therefore, SWOT analysis is very important. The E. C is my conduct. C is my character. C is my do. C is my don'ts. And last key, very important, time consciousness. I am normally never late in my lifetime, anywhere. The key is time consciousness. So there is a perfect formula. Anybody can opt for and you will succeed. Second question was about UD. UD means unique document identification number. Those students who are interested more can go on the ICAI website and see the UD, but I'll give the background. Sometime in 2010, in Pune, in one of the cooperative banks, one chartered accountant was reviewing the documents. And to his surprise, he found that this is a document signed by his friend. Those were the financial statements, profit and loss account and balance sheet. Based on that, lakhs of rupees loan was given by the cooperative bank. So casually, a chartered accountant telephoned to his friend, right? Your particular financial statement signed is here. This client is there. He said, to my surprise, I don't have this client. Right? Then whose name is this? Thereafter, they met for a cup of tea on the same day. And they found entire financial statement document was old. Same type of stamp, same membership number, same similar type of signature, and it was totally forged. So based on the forged document, the bank has sanctioned loan of lakhs of rupees.
Both the chartered accountant came to me along with the statement copies. And then we have gone to the police also. Police has not accepted. They couldn't understand. But finally, going to the police commissioner, finally the case was accepted. And the man was arrested also. They found out. It was found out. Because who has done it? One of the article clerk who couldn't pass the CA examination has done this tactic. And he has signed this statement. But his sister was a lawyer. By the time he was relieved from custody, entire documentary evidence has vanished. The computer, those rubber stamps, those different type of signatures, whatever put. Then question arose, what next? I said, what is this? There's a failure. I couldn't do anything. I have to prevent it. Prevention is better than cure. The matter was taken before the council of the institute. And at that particular time, I suggested this UDIN. So this unique document identification number before a chartered accountant sign any statement, whether it is financial certificate or the general purpose financial statement or whether any particular report, before he signed, he has to take from the institute's technical system the unique document identification number, a serial number for a document which will not be there for the second document. Now, in addition to his name, membership number, FRN, firm's registration number, he has to also write UDIN. Once he has signed these documents, he has to enter into the institute system and he has to give some cross-check figures, which are not known to anybody. Cross-check figure may be a balance in bank account, balance in plant and machinery account, balance in calculator account, computer account, whatever it is. Now, suppose I am a user. I received a statement in a bank signed by Yashwant Kasar. Okay, all right. Now, how do I check up whether this document is genuine? He can enter, the user can enter in the institute system and he can cross-verify. He will get temporary password and he will enter the institute system and he'll find whether these cross figures, minimum 2, maximum can be 6 also, whether these are there in the document. If the answer is yes, this is a genuine document, otherwise document will be forged one. My dear friends, millions of signatures are already, urines are generated by the system, and it is a system whereby the forgery is so-called is prevented, and this is accepted by governmental organizations also. This is accepted by the SAFA Countries Association also. This is accepted by my EOSSG member countries also. So there is a wide usage for the program prevention of forgery. Yes, Yashwant.
Yashwant, sir.
Yes.
Before proceeding to next question, we are having one surprise announcement. Gaurav sir, with your due presence and due permission, we want to make one announcement regarding online crash course. Make what is a regarding MCQ series. So can we make one announcement, sir, for 2 minutes?
Yes. What is that you said?
Aditi ma'am, over to you.
Okay,
we are launching MCQ series.
Okay. So hello everyone. Sir, this is the first time we're meeting though. And for everybody else, guys who are waiting for the announcement, I'm here to just tell you, as promised, as in my sessions I told you, we'll be conducting MCQ sessions. So we have this coming up from tomorrow. From tomorrow onwards, we have a session on MCQs, okay? Which for audit, law, for ISCA, for DT, and for IDT. We're going to have MCQ session, which will be live. Like my session also, I know. We're doing it from tomorrow evening. Okay, so ensure that you are attending it live, because you'll just enjoy it when it is live. If it is not live, it's no fun. ठीक है बाद में रिकॉर्डेड दिखने में नो फन एंजॉय यू कम ऑन टाइम एंड वी कीपिंग इट इन द इवनिंग्स सो दैट ड्यूरिंग द डे यू कैन स्टडी करेंटली द शेड्यूल इट बिगिंस tomorrow. So 2nd June it begins. So tomorrow evening I'm going to see you for doing law first. How are we going to do this? We'll be having MCQs, not oral. Obviously, as we did our everything on PPT, we'll do the same thing. You'll have our MCQs coming up, 4 options. You'll be given time to think. Once you get the answer, we'll discuss the answer. How did it come and everything? We're trying to do as many chapters as I can. But as initially announced, I want all of you to, hi guys, good afternoon. I can read all your messages. Great to see you guys also. I was waiting, when do I come to get back to you? So ensure you're done with revising the whole directors, at least for tomorrow, so that we can do maximum questions of directors. After that, let's see how do things turn up and the chapters that, you know, you want. If there's something that you really want to do, then try. Otherwise, directors 3 chapters would be a sufficient practice of all the MCQs. So ensure that you guys are studying the MCQs. Are you studying the whole content? And then MCQs will be done. As I've told you in the session also, you need not study any list of 2,000 MCQs and 5,000 MCQs. Nothing. Content, if you've read properly, अच्छे से content पढ़ लिया, आ जाओ कल, हम सारे MCQs कर लेंगे. So we are doing it from tomorrow. After that, we have for all the faculties. This is something that I had personally promised all of you that हम MCQs करेंगे. And with the support of Satara branch, Rishikesh sir and all other branches, Solapur branch, Sangli, Solapur, Ishikirindi, Aurangabad, Ratnagiri, Kalyan, Domyoli, Thane, Nasik, Pimpri, Chinchwad, Goa, Amravati, Vapi, Lucknow, Jodhpur and Durgapur. I have named them all. So with all their collective efforts, we are able to do this for you. Ensure you attend it live and make the most of it. And you know, apne ko live mein zyada maza aata hai. So ensure you come tomorrow. I'm sorry to disrupt your whole session for this announcement, but this is something which I had to announce and this was the time slot. So see you very soon, guys. Thank you, Rishikesh sir. Over to you.
Yes. Thank you, madam, for your wonderful announcement. We will meet tomorrow. Now I request Yashwant sir to carry on the session forward.
Yes, Rishikesh. Actually, we have taken a lot of time from sir. Since last 2 years, sir is giving us inputs, guiding the students. And what is most important is what sir said in his session, that instead of being motivated for a day or a week, you should stay motivated throughout your journey. So with that message, I think we should stop here and hand over to you. Or if some questions are there from students, if you want to take. You can take.
Yes. One question from Swapnil Naik, sir. For sir, in architecture training, in mid-sized firm, are able to do. Yeah.
Okay. Is architecture training is mid-sized firm? We are not able to do statutory audit. What is the solution of learning statutory audit? Okay, mid-sized firm and there is no statutory audit, I am not able to understand. Because even the small firm, also there are statutory audits. What do you mean by statutory audit? Audit as per statute. There may be NGO, audit is under statute. Even the tax audit is under statute. Companies, under the Companies Act statute. So my dear friend, this is not possible for a small or a medium firm, that there is no statutory audit as such. Statutory audit is there. And please keep in mind, statutory audit is not what I said. Articleship exposure has added advantage as far as examination is concerned. And I have given you a practical example how it helped me. It helped many students at all the time. Therefore, another suggestion I have given you, have a friend circle of 4-5 students who are dedicated and committed, share. Unless and until you are able to share, you will not be able to take your care. And unless you take your care, you will not be able to dare. So please keep in mind, have a good friend circle and share the ideas with each other, share the knowledge with each other. By sharing the knowledge, your knowledge is not getting reduced. Your knowledge is on the one to increase and crystallize.
Yes. I think there are no more questions. Prabhaji, you are saying, can you ask my question? But I am not able to see your question. So without wasting time, I will request Gaurav sir to have a few words.
Yes, thank you, CA Rishikesh. I think I've been associated with Zaure sir for the last 1 or 2 years through the Goa branch. We are handling a very complex matter of our ICAI Bhavan Goa, and I can testify to his dedication, his enthusiasm, and his meticulousness in the entire matter. He has guided us right from day one, even till today, till yesterday. I think on Saturday we had a discussion. So he's following it up as if it is his own project rather than it's our project. So we feel very obligated to him, and I feel that this is the way you have to conduct yourself in a professional life. So really hats off to you, sir. I think even Kasar sir will testify that whenever you all come to Goa, even if the earlier day session goes up to 11 o'clock, next day morning sir has to go to his morning walk on that beach of Miramar Beach compulsorily. So we hope to have you back soon, sir, once the lockdown ends, so that you can again enjoy your beach walk with us. So thank you, sir, for this enlightening session today. Over to you, Rishikesh.
Thank you very much.
Yes. Now I request, I request Kaushik Gada, the Vikasa chairman of Kalyan Dombivli branch, to give concluding remarks.
Yeah, hello, everyone. Good afternoon, Javre, sir. Good afternoon, Yashwant ji. Hello, am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible, sir.
Yeah. Thanks, Rishikesh, for giving me this opportunity. And I really want to, you know, thank Zaureshar. He's very well known among the students. And today we have Shishya Guru as well with all of us. I always heard Yashwant ji always telling about Zaureshar as his mentor, guru, and everything. And today we have heard him, all of them, live. And I always remember Zaure sir, once I heard somewhere in one of his talks about, you know, this commitment about morning walks. And that has already, you know, touched my heart, and I have been doing this regularly. And thus physical activity is very important for me as well, you know. And for last 20, for one and a half years, I have lost my weight by around 20 kgs, and I have been maintaining this. So this very is one good thing, physical activities is very important for your health and for your all activities, and that's very inspiring. And I hope today all the students, you know, will take whatever his suggestions, whatever his experience has said, his experience will definitely, you know, the live experience that he has shared with all of all the students, and definitely it must be very inspiring and useful for all of us. And all for the all the students, you should definitely take this something very useful. And thanks, Gaurav, for chairing, you know, for this session along with this Satara branch. And it was really wonderful to, you know, again listen to Zaure sir and Yashwant ji on this live webinar on this inspirational talks. Thank you, everyone. I hope you all enjoyed this session. And thank you, sir, for your valuable time and your inputs at a very crucial time.
Thank you very much. How many students are there, Rishikesh? How many join?
Right now, 112 were there.
Thank you.
Yes, Kaushik ji, it was very wonderful concluding remarks. And I also want to thank Gaurav ji for handling this session in this technical failure also. Very thank you. Thank you, Yashwant sir, for your very wonderful interview session. Thank you, Dhauri sir, for your wonderful guidance and sparing your very, very valuable time. And more importantly, I also thank Aditi Chaturvedi ma'am for taking this painstaking efforts for guiding the students in this lockdown period wholeheartedly. I thank you all the students for participating here, the watching live lectures. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Rishi.
Thank you. Prabhaji, we will answer this question soon. Thank you very much. Prabhaji, we will answer your question. इन द मनोज सर का सेशन में हम क्वेश्चन का आंसर कर लेंगे. So guys, we will end the session now. Thank you very much. Thank you all the students for your great motivation and support. Thank you very much. So see you soon. Aaj new syllabus ka lecture hai 2 baje live session rahega. So don't miss it. Thank you.